Could this be our first look at the iPhone Air's battery? The Apple MagSafe battery is back. Well, sort of. I should say an Apple MagSafe battery is back, made exclusively for the iPhone Air. Owing to its slim design, this new battery seems to exist purely to get the iPhone Air through a full day's use with an additional 65% capacity. According to Apple, that should bring the Air up to 44 hours video playback time. Hang on a minute though, this battery pack is thicker than the iPhone Air, so you'd expect to have a much bigger battery inside. Why only 65% additional charge? Let's crack it open and find out. The only entry point I can see is hinted at by the seams around the face. I'm just hoping this case isn't glued shut like AirPods are. A few minutes of heat and a bit of help from my heavy-duty suction cup creates the gap I need to get my opening pick in. It takes more force than I'd like, but sliding the pick all the way around cuts the adhesive and separates the plastic shell from the body. Unfolding the two halves of the shell reveals a very shiny encased battery with two familiar looking tabs that suggest we have electrically releasing adhesive underneath. But first things first, I'll disconnect that battery to make the device safe to work on. Next up, I'm gonna break out my iFixit portable power station, and using the iFixit vault clip, which you can buy in our store, I can feed 12 volts into those strips. The electric current runs through each contact point, forcing a chemical reaction that breaks down the adhesive under the battery. The result is that after a couple of minutes, hey presto, the battery is magically released. The steel encased battery is a 12.26 watt hour cell with a very interesting profile. Instead of the straight lines we're used to seeing on a rectangular or L-shaped battery, we have an odd protrusion at the bottom and very precise and subtle curves on two of the straight edges. That's a bit odd until you consider that this might in fact be the same battery that is in the iPhone Air, and that shape is designed to fit inside an iPhone Air. We got a glimpse of the Air's battery during the Apple event, and it sure looks like a close match. At about 2.7 millimeters, it's thin enough to fit inside the 5.6 millimeter iPhone Air too. This also might help explain why you only get 65% out of the Apple MagSafe battery pack that's designed for the iPhone Air. Energy transfer from one power source to another is never going to be 100% efficient. Add to that the fact that wireless charging in particular is very wasteful in the energy transfer process, and that 65% figure starts to make sense. As far as the thickness of the case goes, at a guess I'd say this was the minimum required to make a viable product. Remember, unlike the sturdy titanium shell on the iPhone Air, this battery is only protected by plastic, which needs to be thick enough to protect the internals. That adds bulk to the design. So there's a little bit of iPhone battery inception going on here, but I do love the fact that Apple didn't fire up an entirely new production line just to make batteries for the iPhone Air MagSafe battery pack. Having said that, it would have been nice if disassembling the battery pack was a little bit easier. As it is, it's unlikely that the average person is going to be able to open one of these up to replace the battery inside. That does make me wonder, will it be just as difficult to get into the iPhone Air? Make sure you're subscribed to our channel, and we'll be taking a look at the iPhone Air in just a couple of days.